There are many ways to get your animation data from Morph-O-Matic to your game engine. But today, I will show you Morph-O-Matic's Game Engine Integration Scripting API. So we have a head here, animated with morph targets using Morph-O-Matic inside of 3ds Max. One technique several of our customers have used over the years is to simply save a Morph-O-Matic.mom file, and to choose what type of data you wish to save. You could save the geometry, the information about each of the morph targets. You could also save the animation, the keyframes, the value of the keyframes, the Bezier handle values, among other options. You can save all of this to a single file on your disk. .mom files are ASCII based, which means you can easily load the file and choose the parts you need out of all the information you have previously saved to it. Like I've said before, this method has been available for many years. A recent addition to Morph-O-Matic is a series of additional Max script commands. These commands bring you deep into the heart of Morph-O-Matic, the information of the targets. By evaluating some lines of the script, we can see how many channels we have, and you will also notice that each of these channels display their specific amount of targets and vertices. This script also provides very detailed information on the vertices and their exact position. We can easily add a couple of lines in a game exporter and simply export the morph values and the morph channel vertices from each of the targets to the game engine. So we can very easily integrate the setup of scenes we have created in 3ds Max with the game engine exporter, just using a couple of lines of Max script and the help of Morph-O-Matic's Game Engine Integration Scripting API. Thank you for watching this video on the integration of Morph-O-Matic with your game engine. Feel free to download the trial version of Morph-O-Matic on our website at www.di-o-matic.com.